Hey everybody, welcome. My name is Kurt, aka The Vitruvian Gamer, and I'm here with something new, something short this time, some things I can do each week. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a weekly pack of, a weekly booster pack of Star Wars Destiny. So what I'm going to do is, I bought Star Wars Destiny. That's one thing I did. I played it a few times, so I really like it. But this is a collectible card and dice game, which means you have to buy these packs of cards, and each pack comes with a few cards and with a die in it. But of course, this might become a very expensive hobby, and I want to keep it not too expensive. So I'm going to restrain myself from buying too much. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to buy some of these packs. I still have 6 of these lying here in seal, so closed. What I'm going to do is each week I'm going to open one of these and I'm going to film it. And I'm going to show you what's inside. That's it. That's what I'm going to do. That's the plan. If there will be expansions, and there will be expansions because there's one announced already. Some things that focus a little bit on the Rogue One movie. Then I'm probably buy a starter pack and some boosters again. And I will open those. So that's what I will do. Very simple. If you are interested in it, just watch it. If you're not, we'll see. It's just something I would like to do. So each week I will open one of these. And this week is the first time. Now, I did 4 of them in a live playthrough of this game I did with Elisa. But now each week I do 1. So let's see what's in the first week. So again, it is in this piece of cardboard. So we cannot see it yet. So let's just go and watch. Let's make it a little bit mysterious first. So these are the 5 cards that I got this time. And this is the die. It's right over here. And as you can see, this is already a spoiler of who we got. So let's turn around these cards. We got Jango Fett, the little mercenary. And I will just show them cards to you. It is a character, so that's pretty cool. A new character that I can use, that the dark side can use, the villain side, and which is something for Elisa, because Elisa is playing the dark side here at our home. Pretty cool. And after an opponent activates a character, you can activate this character. Ooh, for free. A cool skill that is. All right, we also have anticipate an event being used for the heroes. Force an opponent to choose and resolve any number of their dice in the order of their choice. Then remove all of the dice they did not resolve. Yeah, that's a nasty one. That can be very nasty. We also have the Force is Strong support card. And as an action, exhaust this support and discard a blue card from your hand to play another copy of that card from your hand for free. Pretty cool. Also for the heroes, this one. Then we have an event usable by the villain's boundless ambition. Draw cards up to your hand size. Pretty cool as well. Can be very useful. And let's see, we have riposte. Remove any number of shields from one of your characters, then deal damage to a character equal to the number of shields you just removed. So maximum 3, but it's a free one. That is pretty interesting as well. Let's take a look at the die now of the character we got. So as you can see, it's always on the card as well. So we have a side that does 1 range attack. We have one that even does 2 range attack. Always cool to have. One side with 1 melee of melee, however you want to pronounce it. One that gives you a resource. And one that gives you 1 more resource if you already have a die with a resource. And of course, the one that I roll the most, the one that does nothing. And to end this first unpacking, I would say, is the quote of Jango Fett: "There can be no mistakes this time." And with those words, I thank you for watching, and I invite you for next week when I open a new booster pack of Star Wars Destiny. Thanks, and bye bye.